Synthesis of Acetylsalicylic Acid, ASA. In this experiment, you will be introduced to the organic synthesis of acetylsalicylic acid using salicylic acid and acetic anhydride. Before examining the reaction, however, we must first have a grasp of some basic functional groups. These are alcohols, benzenes, phenols, ketones, aldehydes, carboxylic acids, esters, ethers, and anhydrides. This experiment involves the reagent salicylic acid, which contains the functional group carboxylic acid, and acetic anhydride as an anhydride. The reaction is as follows. Salicylic acid and acetic anhydride react in the presence of sulfuric acid and heat to form acetylsalicylic acid and acetic acid. As you can see, salicylic acid has an alcohol functional group which reacts with the acetic anhydride to form an ester. The acetylsalicylic acid still has the carboxylic acid functional group that the salicylic acid had. The alcohol, however, has been acetylated. The sulfuric acid in this reaction acts as a catalyst. As you may know, acetylsalicylic acid is the main component in aspirin. To start, weigh out approximately 3 grams of salicylic acid into a clean, dry 50 ml Erlenmeyer flask. The following steps all occur in the fume hood, and your flask must remain in the fume hood at all times. Using the dispenser, add 5 ml of acetic anhydride. Acetic anhydride has a strong choking odor and is a lacrimator, which means it causes tearing. This is why these steps must occur in the fume hood. Then, wearing gloves, add 10 drops of 18 molar sulfuric acid and swirl the flask gently. Staying in the fume hood, heat the flask in a 250 ml beaker containing boiling water for 10 minutes. Stir several times with a glass stirring rod. Then remove the flask from the boiling water and add approximately 30 ml of ice water to decompose the excess acetic anhydride. You may now remove the flask from the fume hood. Next, chill the flask in solution thoroughly in an ice bath for 5 to 10 minutes, stirring frequently with a glass stirring rod. It is a good idea to prepare the hot water bath, the ice bath, and the ice water in advance. Next, collect the crude ASA crystals by vacuum filtration using a Buchner funnel. Next, we will be purifying our ASA crystals. To start, add your crude crystals to 6 ml of ethanol. Then, place your beaker in a hot water bath and warm to about 60 degrees Celsius. Once all the ASA crystals have dissolved, take the beaker from the water bath and add 15 ml of warm deionized water. Allow the solution to cool to room temperature. Scratch the beaker using a glass stirring rod to help with crystal formation. Then, cool the solution further in an ice water bath. Once you think you have all the crystals you can get, vacuum filter using the Buchner funnel. When done, turn off the suction and wash the crystals with 10 ml of cold deionized water. Then turn suction back on and allow the crystals to dry as much as possible. Once the crystals are relatively dry, transfer them onto a pre-weighed watch glass. Reweigh the watch glass to determine the mass of crystals, and keep your crystals because they will be needed next week. Now some calculations must be done, starting with theoretical yield. In order to find your theoretical yield, you must first find your limiting reagent, which is the reagent which produces the least number of moles of ASA. To do this, start with your mass of salicylic acid. Then using its molecular weight of 131.15 grams per mole, you can get to the number of moles of salicylic acid. And using your mole ratio from the balanced equation above, you can get to the number of moles of ASA. Next, repeat for acetic anhydride, but there is one more step, as you must go from milliliters of acetic anhydride to grams. For this, you will use the density. Then, once you have mass of acetic anhydride, you will again use your molecular weight, in this case 102.09 grams per mole, to get to moles of acetic anhydride, and then use your mole ratio from the reaction to get to moles of ASA. The reagent which produces the least number of theoretical moles of ASA is then your limiting reagent. Then you can find your theoretical yield using the limiting reagent number of moles. You take your moles of ASA from your limiting reagent, and using the molecular weight of ASA, you can go to the mass of ASA. Then, to find percent yield, you take your experimental mass of ASA and divide it by your theoretical mass of ASA and multiply it by 100. This is a 2-week lab. Next week, we'll be running tests to see how pure our ASA crystals are. These will be melting point and thin layer chromatography, or TLC. Make sure you look up the literature value for the melting points of ASA and salicylic acid before the lab next week. Have fun!